life. And even right now, some things you deal with that you thought were in your past, so you can't tell people that you haven't been delivered because they'll talk about you. And there is a place for a level of transparency that we can no longer have with the saints because they talk about everything. And instead of praying for you,
come on, come on. Something, something.
Always. And so God is negotiating your release. But here, I want to put God in the position of president, and I want to put Judah in the position of the secretary of state. That Judah is the one that is negotiating on your behalf with the earth, with the principality, because you do know that Satan is the prince of the air.
Yes.
And so Judah is negotiating with Satan, the prince of the air. If you don't believe me, over to Job chapter number 1, and the Bible says that Satan entered into the court of heaven, and he asked God, he said, who shall I avenge, who shall I go for? I'm going to and fro, and I can't find anybody to antagonize. Who do you have in mind? And God says, have you considered my servant Job? There is a consideration over your life. There is a warrant over your life, and believe it or not, the thing that you are going through right now is God sent because he wants you to break forth in endurance. Okay, what does that mean, preacher? Well, that means God is applying pressure over your life because he knows that you won't break, but you'll expect. God understands that what you are going through now is not to destroy you, it's not to break you down, but there is a greater glory that is yet to be revealed in your life. If you don't believe me, Romans said, for the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared to the glory which shall be revealed in you. If you don't believe that, the Bible says that there is a treasure in the earthen vessel, that the excellency of power may be of God and not of us. There is something on the inside of you that the enemy wants. There's something on the inside of you that the enemy wants, and if you allow the enemy to win you over, oh my God, if you allow the enemy to win you over, you have lost a battle that has already been won for you. I understand, hallelujah. How come the saints lose the desire or the passion to pray? Okay, I'm going to talk back. I understand, hallelujah. When the saints will come into the house of God, be in the presence of God, and won't even wave their hand no more.
Come on!
Hallelujah. They'll sit down and look at you like something wrong with you, like you got 3 eyeballs or something. And they don't understand that what I'm doing is I'm giving God what's stupid. Though I may not feel like praising God,
come on, sir.
Praise will show up somewhere. So I end my life, and it will negotiate my release.
Yeah.